Hi there, I'm Dr. Andrew Dixon from radiopedia.org, and in this video we're going to take a look at the Jefferson fracture, which is a burst type fracture of C1 due to excessive axial loading, where fractures occur through both the anterior and posterior arches. So here's a case from our iPad app of a 20-year-old male involved in a motorcycle accident. Here's his lateral cervical spine radiograph, and we'll zoom in to show you some of the abnormalities. You can see here that the atlantodens interval is significantly widened. This should normally be less than 3 millimeters. And you can see out the back there's a lucent line through the posterior arch representing a fracture. On the PEG view, we see that both of the lateral masses of C1 are displaced laterally relative to the lateral masses of C2. You can see that here with my laser pointer that C1 is overhanging C2. It should normally be a straight line like this, but you can see that both sides have displaced laterally. Now the only way that can happen is if the arch of C1 is broken in two spots. You see here on the CT that is in fact the case. We can clearly see a fracture line both through the posterior arch and a fracture line here through the anterior arch. Now the other important thing to note is this bone fragment here, which represents an avulsed fragment from the insertion of the transverse ligament. This is a rare but important finding in the setting of Jefferson fracture, as it implies instability and explains why this patient had a widened atlantodens interval on the lateral view. So unlike the vast majority of Jefferson's fractures, which can be managed conservatively with immobilization, this patient may in fact require more definitive surgical management. So there you have it, the Jefferson's fracture of C1. You can find out more on our Radiopedia website, where there are several other case examples, and this case is featured in our Radiopedia iPad app, which can be found in the App Store.